Hello everyone, I'm your host Fluid Ranger and here to answer your question about living in other planets. And to simplify the problem, I will talk only about the solar system planets, as other planets in our galaxy is way far to reach and it will take centuries to get there. So first, let's establish some conditions. The planets that we move into need to be rocky planets, as we can't live in a gassy planet. Just like that, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune are out of the window. That leaves us with Mars, Venus, and Mercury. Second condition, the planet we need to live on need to have atmosphere, as you don't want to get hit by an asteroid while you're working on repopulating another planet. And one asteroid can destroy years or even centuries of work. Fair enough, right? That removed Mercury from the equation, because Mercury doesn't have any atmosphere at all, and it's shrinking, and so sooner or later Mercury will cease to exist. But that's another subject. So now we're left with Venus and Mars. So let's start with Venus. So let's take a close look to Venus. Venus is our neighbor in our solar system, so it's closer than other planets, closer than Mercury. And meet the two primitive conditions that we have. Venus is a rocky planet and also have atmosphere, a very thick atmosphere at that. And it's even more protected than Earth against asteroids thanks to that very thick atmosphere. So it's all good, yeah? We can live on Venus. Wrong. But when we really look at Venus, we find that it has very active volcanoes. More volcanoes than any other planet in our solar system. Some scientists believe that it has even more than 1 million volcanic features. But let's overlook that. It doesn't matter. Volcanoes doesn't matter. And we somehow managed to find a spot that we won't be touched with any of the major volcanic features, which is very hard to do. Second thing we need to notice is the wind of 355 km/h. That's like hurricane category 5 around the clock. That will make it harder to build anything, as it is catastrophic. But for the sake of argument, I have the question in my mind that we dig a little cave for the human to live in, little space caveman. Is that a word? It does matter. Let's not forget about the pressure of the atmosphere caused by the clouds of sulfuric acid. Oh yeah, I forget to say that Venus is the hottest planet in our solar system. So hot that it will melt lead. So if we send the humans to Venus, not only they gonna cook extra crispy, a chance major volcano to explode. You see the problem here? So in other words, Venus is the no-go for now. And I say for now because in 1000 years or 2000, maybe we can be so advanced that we can terraform a planet. But that's another subject for another time. With Venus out of the way, we are only left with Mars. Mars is our only hope. So don't let us down, you beautiful red planet. So let's take a closer look. Mars is rocky. Mars have atmosphere. Even though it's very thin atmosphere, roughly 100 times less dense than Earth's atmosphere. But we don't have to worry about the pressure crushing our space human. Temperature of 20 degrees a day and minus 153 degrees Celsius at night, livable in our current equipment. Mars is also tilted 25 degrees, so there is season changes, just like Earth. And the day on Mars is 24 hours and 37 minutes. So it's only longer than us by 37 minutes. So conclusion, Mars is livable for us. And unless you're living under a rock, you know that NASA is scheduled to send people on Mars. I will link some articles for that in the description if you want to read more about it. But for this video, it's over as we answer the question, can we live on other planets? The answer is yes, but there is more to be said in future videos about living on Mars and why it's not all what it seems. Thank you for watching and have a great day.